it's a very special occasion for me to be surrounded by a lot of people that I admire and respect, and also to be in the context of this exhibition that we just visited this morning. I'm a curator. I'm a freelance curator. So my work as a curator focuses on connection between still image and moving image. And it's a part of a photographic research that I'm doing, that I've been developing since the mid-80s. This research relates to the connection between sound and space, between moving image and sound, between movement and objects, and movement of objects and sound, and as well as silence. And also I'm interested by what I call imaginary sound. So it works without sound, that suggests sound, works that leave a lot of space for the viewer or the listener. This research has resulted in exhibitions, film and video program, text, production of compact disc, conversation also with artists like Karsten and Berndt that they were doing, and also interview that has been printed, and books. I like books, and I like if as possible to insert a CD with the book when I curate sound-related art. I've worked with different artists. Often they are using many media, so I like to move between all these different media. I work with musicians also, and also with artists who are, some call them each other, yeah, they call them sound artists, some they forget, they prefer not to be labeled as sound artists. The notion of trace also is very important for me. I like to focus on the way that images and sound leave their mark upon us, and also to I'm interested by relative transience experiences, fleeting and at time almost imperceptible sounds are very challenge me a lot. Sounds and image, of course. So they manifest themselves to us and inhabit us, and sometimes they can haunt us. I would like to start to show you an exhibition, like documentation of an exhibition I curate in Quebec City in 2004. The title is Frottement, Surface et Objets Sonores, Friction, Sound and Objects Surfaces. The exhibition took place in a building close to the museum. It was in the 19th century a prison, and it has been restored. And the museum dedicated this building to media exhibition. So there was like video installation or sound related work, and also web art. There were like many cells, and in each cell there was a work. So, there were seven artists. They are from Canada. And also there were, sometime when I curate an exhibition with sound, I like to have also the performance element. So there will be concert or action as experience. And sometimes artists will have will exhibit it, but also will perform. So the shape of the cell is very small, so it gives each work a symbolic connotation for sure. But it helps the visitor to be in some kind of isolation and silence sometimes, or retreat from the rest of the world. I thought that the cell was a good space to listen, to have a listening experience. And each cell had an open door, so the sound could leak. But of course, I select the work in relation to this leaking situation. I think I will move to another project that I curated in 2012. It was for a biennial in Quebec City, and the I curate 15 exhibitions on the notion of machine, the shape of movement. And we could look at some, like the diapo one, a series. So you will see it's quite diverse in terms of visual art. There were some kinetic art, but also some video. What you are listening to is a piece from Martin Tétrault that he produced for the Biennial. And he invited 10 artists who are using turntable to register the sound of their turntable, and he made a composition out of that. And he made a sculpture out of it, and he was as if he was directing the 10 turntables. I have a few images. It's a wonderful piece. So kinetic art, video, photographs, drawings, sound works that dealt with the question of the machine. The idea of the machine also was important for me. Functional, utopian, symbolic, mechanical, and also the poetic of movement. So this is it's a piece by Jan Farley. It's an interactive installation with sound. This is there are two pieces by Arthur Ganson. Yeah. Very beautiful project. He's an American who has done a lot of kinetic installation. Mounir Fatmi, American. So I had like in one room there were four works from Mounir Fatmi. So in the background it's modern time. In the foreground it's Merlicht, and we can move to another vision. So you have the sound of the there was soundtrack, but you hear the sound of the neon. And this is a close-up of modern time. Again, Merlicht. And again, there is another one. Yeah, so on the right side, it's the man of the book. So there was silent work and sound. In another room, there were three works with three women. Marla Yadi, she is a sculptor. This is a kinetic sculpture on the table, very tiny, very set, and it's on the notion of level, to be on level. This is a sound sculpture by Sansfield and Oikas. The title is Hearing Voices. And on the left, you have the image of the sound of the earth with garbage in orbit, electronic garbage. And there was a photo, and the artist is playing with notion of scale. This is from Manon Labrec, who is also doing a video performance and kinetic art. In another room, we had Diane Obomserwin. She's an animator. So you can see that I was playing with different notion of motion. And this detail of animation. It was the first time she was doing an installation. Usually she is showing in cinema context. And the Martin Tétrault piece. So you could see that on the wall, you have headphone, you have a pocket of a disc, and you have the 10 turntables, which each of them belongs to the turntables. They send their turntable to Martin. And on the cone, you have the sound of the 10, which was mixing. So Martin did like a sound composition of that work. And there is a tiny ball above, over each turntable. So when the bulb is lit, you hear the sound, but you know from which turntable the sound is coming. And also, it's all these turntables are from different countries. So the idea was to have like an overview of what's happening on the earth with the turntable. So usually Martin is a very modest artist, but that project was really like, on an imaginary level, was very stimulating. And the end of you can see more. And I end up the exhibition with a work by Brian Gesin and Jan Somerville, Dream Machine, a silent work, and also a work that you experience with your eyes closed. So again, with the machine, so this work is by Mini Block. It's a duo, Anne-Françoise Jacques and Nicolas Dion. They are from Montreal. And this piece is Courant d'air, air current. So we can look at, now with the video you had like a close-up of the installation, but the whole gallery was filled by these objects, simple. And these two guys are really aware of the acoustic and the property of diffusion, so you can just go quickly. It's a bit, it's very generous. So they spend a lot of time in the gallery to comment on the what Karsten Seffert was saying, that sometimes some gallery will allow the artist to be there for like 10 days and experiment and even construct the piece. And also they were not sure the organization of the whole setup. So it was really interesting to see how they work together and how they fill the space, and also when they decided that this was the exhibition. And after that, of course, the visitor could walk through the end. There was some circuit. So sometimes all the elements will play together. Sometimes there will be three, four. And it was very subtle, very about like you have to be close sometimes to the cone, to hear, or to be at a distance, and you will have like the whole composition. I would like another work, which was shown also at Machine, and it's the it's the work of an artist, a Japanese artist, Kanta Oryo, and he spent also 10 days in Quebec City, first to gather material and to build his installation. It's a sound and light installation. Kanta is a wonderful artist and in situ installation, but also a wonderful performer. And so during this project in Quebec City, I invited him to do a performance. And he was playing with the space and being on two floors and doing a lot of mechanic and sound. So now we are going back in time. It's a project that was done in 2005. In a artist one, in a gallery, university gallery, and I will go very quickly because I think it's. I want to show it's the title was Tracé, Retracé, Tracking the Traces. So there were many different artists. So this is a sound draw. It's a drawings on the wall. So after a month, the wall was really the drawing was really dense. It's a work by Jean-Pierre Gauthier. So a detail of it. So this is kinetic, and it leaves traces. This is a work again from Martin Tétreau. It's based on the character of Ringo Starr. So Martin has sandblast the pocket, the sleeves of the vinyl, and he kept only a detail of Ringo. So he built a fiction around this. Drummer. So you could see different angles, and so you have in the pocket like the remnants of, and this is a composition that was interpreted after that in the exhibition by a drummer, and only drum. This is a work by Frederick Jorgensen. So it was a table with sound CD and headphone, and you go through the file of this Swedish artist. And in front was his image that was taken from a television after his death. So it's really about EVP, electronic voice phenomena. This is a piece by Peter Schuli, a Hungarian artist. He found a Super 8 by Béla Bartók, who is doing a piano concert in New York, and there is no soundtrack. And the project was to try to find which piece Bartók was playing and to put the sound on the film. And so you have two musicologists trying to find what is the piece. And this is really about listening and also how you listen, but if you are a musician or a pianist and you know the piece, you have the piece in yourself. The woman was wonderful how she's explaining how she find out about this project. This is another piece about listening. The drummer is listening to 100 excerpts of sound, 10 seconds. And you have to find what is the rhythm. And it's a piece by an artist by Jan Murray. And it was the top 10 of the 17. So it's very popular, the music. And but you see again that there is a connection between the ear and the hand and how the sound are like processed in the image, in the memory. A piece by Lynn Pook. German French artist, and she put a little tiny speakers on your body, and after that she diffused a sound piece, and it's very interesting because you get the sound through your own body, through the bone, in some way it connects with your project. This is a piece by Dominique Petitgant, four speaker, a wonderful artist from France, based on voice. So you have to believe me because you have no sound. So I leave you with this. So it gives an idea of how I connect works. And oh, this interest in sound and silence is there, ongoing. Merci.